Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. And in this video, I want to show you how to kind of spruce up your website a little bit if you're using Beaver Builder. Now, there's multiple ways to do what I'm going to show you, and I'll make it clear if you need the free version or the paid version or some other tool. I'm going to try to make it so you can do the same thing even if you have the free version of Beaver Builder. So I actually came across this. I'm on the Ultimate Add-ons website. And what this is a module that they added to their plugin called an image separator. And what it allows you to do is put an image smack dab in the middle of two rows of content to spruce it up. And I'm gonna show you how to do it in their plugin, but I'm also gonna try to do it in the normal Beaver Builder plugin as well, so everyone can be included in this video. Here's some creative examples how they have it. You see there's an image in the middle. Right here there's an image in the middle. Right here there's one, and this one's actually really neat how they did this, where the earth there kind of lines up right in the middle. It's pretty cool. And so let's see if we could do that in Beaver Builder. So here I am on a test site for Beaver Builder, and I loaded up one of the templates. I didn't put too much thought into it. I just thought this might be a good template. So this is really a good trick to put maybe a company emblem or some kind of company symbol to in between two rows to kind of separate it some and just make your website stand out just a little bit more. Now, if you go over to my website, or if you're watching this on YouTube, I'll have a link in the description. I'm going to give you this download right here. It's going to include the Adobe Illustrator version of these images, so you can change the color and just the normal PNGs. So if you know how to work with graphics or have someone that does, they can easily change these colors. And it's a series of icons that you can use as row separators. So the one I want to use is this right here, this quotes. And I think this would be great to go right above a testimonial area. So let's see, if I scroll down here, this might be a testimonial area right here, or maybe something right here. Maybe if there's a dollar sign right there, but why don't I go ahead and just try to put it right there. Now, this is gonna work best, these images. When you see this area here, it's white, and there's a slight white perimeter around the circle. So I'm going to change the color of this background to white so it just looks good. So first I'm going to go ahead and click on launch page builder. Now there's a couple ways I said to do this, and first I'm going to show you the ultimate add-on way with the ultimate add-on module, and then I'm going to show you how to try to get the same effect with just the normal Beaver Builder, and I'll show the pros and cons of each. So I'm going to scroll down to the section here. So first I wanted to make this background white just so that it looks better with the image. Actually, I won't do that. I'll put the image in and then show you. So I'm going to go to add content, and it's under here called image separator, and it is right here, and I'm going to just drag and drop that right there. Okay, so now I need to select a photo, and I'm gonna click on that. I already have that quotation there, but I also have this one of me and this one there, but let's just use this quotation because that's what I said. And I'm gonna drop it in there, and there you have it. It's smack dab in the middle of these two. Now I need to set a color, a row color to match what's above it right here where this image is. But you can see how it perfectly lines it up right there. And if I wanted it to be smaller, I can adjust the size right here to say 100. And it's gonna make that just a little bit smaller, but it's still smack dab in the middle there, which is perfect. Okay, and you can do some other stuff. If it was an image that already wasn't perfectly a circle, you can make it a circle or a square or something along those lines. And there's other things that you could do to maybe push it up a little or push it down, but by default, it's gonna be smack dab in the middle. And you can also add an animation. So I'm not gonna do any of that. I'm gonna just make it look better here. So I'm gonna click on save. And so I said in this section I was gonna make white. So let's do that now. I can either make this section white to match the white, or I can make this section's background match this brown. But I'm gonna go ahead and make this one white. And it looks like it's set as a photo, but I'm gonna make it a color. And I'm gonna make that color white and then click on save. So there you can see how it perfectly is in the middle. Let me click on this live preview button and you can see exactly how that fits perfectly. I really like this. It adds just that extra little bit to your website. And essentially all web design is taking blocks of text and making it look really good with your images on single pages. And this is just something that adds to it. So now you can see how it is done in Ultimate Add-ons. Now, the advantage of Ultimate Add-ons is it's perfectly mobile responsive, but we could do the same thing in the normal Beaver Builder. So let me go back here. And why don't I do the same thing right here for the normal Beaver Builder? So this is what I would do. I would go to add content and I would go to, let me scroll back there, right there. I would go to where the basic module is and I would choose the photo and I would put that right there at the top. And then I'm going to choose the same photo, which is this right here. And let's see how we're looking so far. So it's just gonna put the image there. Now we need to push it up. And the way we're gonna do that is with something called a negative margin. So I think I will go a negative 90. And you can see right there, I don't know if that's perfectly in the middle. It might be, maybe I might need to do a negative 100. That looks like it's a little too pushed up. So maybe 90 was it. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. And you can do this with the free or the paid version of Beaver Builder with your image. And you see it looks nice. So let me save this and show you what it looks like in a mobile phone. So when we save it on the desktop, it's probably gonna look just as good. So there it is right there. And I made that a little smaller. On second thought, I don't think I got it perfect, but that's okay. That's one of the nice things about this right here with Ultimate Add-ons is it's gonna be perfect. So we'll go with this. Now, let me switch my browser into responsive design mode. And what this allows me to do, it's in Safari web browser, it allows me to see what my page will look like on these different devices right here. So I'll go to the iPhone 6 Plus because that's what I use. And this is what the website will look like. Now, when you scroll down, you can see this is how it looks with how we did it, the Beaver Builder method that anyone can do. You can see it's not in the middle anymore. But when you scroll down, you can see the one with Ultimate Add-ons is still perfectly in the middle. So this is just a video of how you could do this image separator with Ultimate Add-ons, or you can use the normal Beaver Builder to do it. If I was using the normal Beaver Builder, I would set that image to just not even show when someone's on a mobile device, because it'll look better to not have it at all than to have it pushed down. So, hey, if you're interested in Ultimate Add-ons or Beaver Builder, I have links down below in the description, or if you're in my website, I have them down below as well. I want you to know those are affiliate links, which means if you click through and you make the purchase, I get a nice little credit from those software developers. And what I want to do for you as a thank you, I have a course called Beaver Builder Essentials, and you could purchase this course for $47. However, if you buy Beaver Builder or Ultimate Add-ons, you can forward the receipt to me. I'll make sure that you made the purchase through my link, and I'll give you access. I'll gladly give you access to this course for free. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.